Hello, today we're talking to Harry from New Zealand. Harry is an opera singer and he's just completed his time as a 2020 Dame Malvina Major Foundation Studio artist, and he's currently in London pursuing a Master's in Performance from the Royal College of Music. So Harry, tell us, how did you just know that this is what you were meant to do when being an opera singer?
It's a great question. I think for me, it was a lot about the love of singing before I discovered my love of opera. And I mean, I think all opera singers are inherently noisy people. And I was a very noisy child. And so my parents decided to get me singing lessons. And so I just continued with my singing lessons, and my teachers began to introduce me to this wonderful art form that is opera and how expressive and beautiful the singing can be. And from that, I have fallen in love with the art form. I went to university in New Zealand. In 2015, I started at the University of Otago, and that's where I completed my first Bachelor of Music, majoring in voice performance, much like here. And so it was there that I really started looking at opera as an art form.
And how did you find yourself at the Victoria League Student House?
A teacher of mine had suggested the Victoria League, and then a few weeks later I was approached by the Kiritakanawa Foundation, who have a relationship with the Victoria League in Auckland, and they have a scholarship for singers. And so I applied and put myself forward and was lucky enough to get the scholarship, and that's why I'm here. I'm so grateful to the Kiritakanawa Foundation and the Auckland branch of the Victoria League, because I get to stay in this amazing house.
So what would you say are the challenges of being a young opera singer in today's day and age? And what are your thoughts on introducing opera to a younger audience today?
Most opera singers aren't ready to go until their late 20s to early 30s. And so there's a lot of time spent training, which is what I'm doing, and a combination of waiting for the body to grow and develop, and learning the technique, because some of this music is it's all beautiful, but it's so, so hard. And I mean that in the best way. It's an incredible challenge. A lot of people compare singers to athletes, which we totally are, because our body and our voices are our job. Right. And so it's really important to be really diligent about looking after ourselves. As to introducing opera to a new audience, I think what is really important to remember is that opera is just storytelling. Opera is storytelling with some bit of singing and some really beautiful music. During my time as a Dame Malvina Major studio artist with New Zealand Opera earlier this year, I was lucky enough to go on a schools tour where we took a shortened down opera of about 45 minutes and we toured schools for about a month. And what was amazing about that is these kids they loved it, because they had no preconceptions about opera was, and to them it's just storytelling and dressing up and singing. That's all it is. It's people in wigs and dresses singing some fun songs. What's been amazing about COVID, you've got to find the positive somewhere, is that opera companies and people are making the most of technology. And so there are complete libraries now of full operas that you can watch for free online, and you don't need to know anything.
You've not had a chance to really explore London, considering you've just been here for 3 months now. So what are you looking forward to once the lockdown is up?
Oh, so many things. I think that I'm most excited to hopefully perform again live. Okay. It's been so bizarre to not perform for an audience. But also it's simple things like going out to dinner with friends and hanging out. And I'm a lover of art galleries and museums. So hopefully when I have some off days, I can go and explore those, masked and socially distanced, of course. But
absolutely.
I mean, yeah. Is all of London a good answer? I just want to see all of it.
So who do you consider your mentor, and what is the most valuable lesson that they've taught you?
It takes a village to raise a baby. And I think the same is true of it takes a village to raise an opera singer. There's so much training that goes on. One piece of advice that I was given, which really resonated with me, is to just do the work. Because opera is such a subjective art form, it's really easy to start comparing yourself and comparing your journey to others. And it's the biggest waste of time because we're all different people and have a different trajectory. So yeah, so this idea of just doing the work, to just show up, do your best and work as hard as you can, and the product speaks for itself.